But for the moment, as promised, we are going to speak about AU Small Finance Bank. That's on our radar because loan growth has been very robust due to customer acquisitions and new product offerings. The bank has also benefited from having no microfinance portfolio, so stable asset quality. Uttam Tibrewal, the executive director, joins us. Uttam, good morning. Thanks a lot for joining us. I'll come to the loan growth in just a bit. How are you tackling the rise in yields? Is that going to make any difference to your margins?
Hi, good morning, Lata. Good morning, CNBC. Thanks for being here to speak for AU. So regarding yields, Lata, you can see that on an NBFC platform, our cost of borrowing was high. And as soon as we became the bank in last April 19, we started bank, our cost of borrowings quarter on quarter, month on month going low. We are acquiring more customers towards CASA and term deposits. My overall borrowings is now around 8.5, 8.6 as compared to 11.5 as compared to NBFC. And my incremental cost is around 6.7 around, you know,
okay,
due to CASA. And my yields are again on retail platform, retail bank is around 15% still, plus upfront fees and other incomes, third party product income. So as we always said that AU Bank is focused on higher yields and we are insulated the kind of markets I'm into, the kind of customer I cater. So it should be high yield, proper yield, and we are focusing on our margins. At the same time, as my cost of borrowing is going down, we are passing on these margins to customers so that I acquire more customers, more organized customers going forward.
So, but how is the credit sentiment now in the SME business loan sub-segment? Because so far, at least the last time we spoke to you, you said the sentiment was quite muted. Has it picked up?
Yeah, it's getting picking up every month. I can see that. Post demon and post GST, there was some pause and customer was not knowing what to. The clarity was not there towards the GST and everything, but I think things are clearing now, and because of good monsoon in our geography, rural cash flows are increasing, and MSME is getting better. They are getting used to GST now, and lot of informal MSMEs are coming to now formal sector. They are into GST. So I am seeing a great hope, and I think my MSME portfolio is growing by 45% quarter-quarter, you know. So I am hopeful, quite hopeful towards this MSME business. And as I can tell you that there are around 400 million small informal MSMEs business there in India, which doesn't have access to credit, you know.
Okay.
So I am chasing that opportunity. So as an AU, we are into that geography, that customer segment. I'm quite hopeful for those towards this MSME business.
Okay, yeah. So what can you guide in terms of a loan growth in the current year and more importantly in FY19?
So historically, if you see my 20 years of journey, there's unbroken services towards customers, towards stakeholders, towards my employees. I'm growing continuously for last 20 years by 35% to 40% consistently, and on bank platform also from last year I am growing with the same pace, 35% to 40%. So we are conscious also, we are careful also, and at the same time I can see that the kind of size I am into, the kind of geography I am into, I am still to manage the same growth of 35% to 40%. I am quite hopeful about that.
Okay. Cost to income ratio obviously has risen because you are putting up new branches, but will you peak off at 57% or will it go even higher?
I think this is a peak because on NBFC platform it was around 38% to 40%, even lower than that. But as you know that we have built up new infrastructure, 300 branches, whole of latest state of the art technology we have built in, my SLR, CRR carry, 4,000 new employees have joined. So that that I put on pressure on my cost to income ratio. I think 57 is peaked out. From here, month on month, quarter on quarter, we'll get better and we'll get lower and we'll somewhere settle around 50-52 going forward. Yeah.
In terms of branches, you do have some expansion plans, I understand. Can you take us through how many branches you have currently and what the plan is over the next 1 to 2 years?
So when we started the bank, I started with 200 branches, bank branches. Now, at present, I am around 305 branches, bank branches, plus 105 asset centers, and some around 20-23 offices, different offices. And going forward, by March 31st, I'm going to start some 90 to 100 odd unbanked branches. which is a mandate from RBI also. In and all, by March end, I'll be having 500 touch points within this 11 states, which where we are working as an AU as of now.
Okay, yeah. And finally, what are you targeting in terms of an asset quality? Your GNP, gross NPAs, have been coming down. So what's the likely year in number?
So, Ratha, you know that in our kind of retail customer and the business, second half always been a good, and more importantly, quarter four. So if you see my delinquency numbers, I think gross I'm somewhere at 2.8% and net somewhere at 1.8%. And I can tell you that month on month, I am reducing in absolute amount, not in percentage. Because as an NBFC, we always focus on absolute amount. So every month we are reducing our 90 plus and very hopeful for this March end also. I think our delinquencies are able to manage one of the best in industry as of now, the kind of yields and customer and products I'm into. So I think it will get better from here.
Okay, well, thank you for joining us hope you have a smooth next few quarters as you suggested. But that's the word coming in from AU Small Finance Bank. Let's move on to the big CNBC TV.